Hello, I'm Bobby Galuba with OobaTech.com, and welcome to my 20th video, recorded on Sunday, November 20th, 2016. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to replace the windshield wiper blades on a 2003 Chevrolet Avalanche. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is talk about the tools and supplies that I think I'll need for this repair. Now, number one are my safety glasses. Now this, since I'm only replacing the windshield wiper blades, this repair should probably be pretty safe and simple, but I never want to cut corners, especially when it comes to safety. And I learned my lesson about this many years ago when I was cleaning some corrosion off the battery terminals for the battery for my truck with a dental pick, and I thought it was going to be a pretty simple, easy, and safe repair, and so I didn't wear any safety glasses. But boy, that was a big mistake, because as I was chipping away at the corrosion on the battery terminals, a little piece of corrosion flew right up into my eye, and I got lucky. I was able to get the corrosion out of my eye with no problem. It didn't cause any injuries or anything like that, but after that, I've always made sure to wear my safety glasses for any repairs on my vehicles or any other things. Okay, now the next thing that I'm going to have and I'm going to wear are my gloves. Now, again, this is probably going to be a pretty simple and easy repair, and these will probably just mainly keep me from getting my hands too dirty. You don't really need gloves probably, but it's always a good idea just to protect your hands. And they also provide a good grip on your tools as well. Now, the next thing you might not have considered is something like this, which is, this is a window shade. Now, I'm not going to use it to shade the truck from the sun, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it on the windshield so that when I have the windshield wiper blade off of the windshield wiper arm, if I accidentally let go of the arm, I'll have this on my windshield and it'll protect the windshield from getting cracked by the arm if I accidentally let go of the arm. Because when you don't have the windshield wiper on there, the arm is just a bare piece of metal, and if you let go of it, it can smack into your windshield and crack the glass. So you want to have something like this, which is a sunshade for your window. You can put that on the outside of the windshield, or you can use an old blanket or like a folded up cardboard box. Now, the next tool I think I'll need is a flathead screwdriver. And the reason why I think I'll probably need this is to pry open the tab on the old windshield wiper blades so that I can slide them off the windshield wiper arm. So I'll use this, and I'll show you how I'll show you how this comes into play when I go and take off the old windshield wiper arms. Okay, and lastly, what I'm gonna need are new windshield wiper blades. Okay, now these are what are called sill blades. And as you can see here, their slogan is lasts years, not months. So I wanted to try to get a set of blades that I wouldn't have to replace anytime soon. So I found these and I read some of the reviews on the internet about them. And according to the reviews, they actually do last several years. So hopefully many, many years from now, I can make another video and show you when I have to replace these. Okay, so these particular ones are WB122S's. Okay, so that, these are 22-inch blades for a 2003 Chevrolet Avalanche. Now, the old wiper blades that I currently have on my Avalanche are 22-inch Trico brand Neoform wiper blades. I looked in my little vehicle service log that I keep, and I purchased those for $32.09 for the pair, and I installed them on Friday, April 12th of 2013, and my mileage at the time was 113,038 miles on the truck. Okay, so that's just as a reference. So those blades lasted a little over 3.5 years, which is pretty good for wiper blades. All right, but now they're starting to fall apart, and so they need to be replaced. Now, the sill blade wiper blades, you can go to their website, and let's take a look at the page here. You can go to www.sillblade.com, and let's see here. I put in the information for my vehicle, which is a 2003 Chevrolet Avalanche 1500, okay, and the blades that it came back with for its search results were the Sill Blade WB122S premium silicone wiper blade, premium silicone wiper blades, which are 22 inches long. And again, the part number is WB Whiskey Bravo 122S as in Sierra. Okay, and on their website, they are $26.25 each. All right, now I was able to find these for a little bit cheaper price. Let's see here. I was able to find those on Amazon.com. And when I purchased them, they were actually a little bit cheaper than they are now. I was able to get them for $13.40 each, but they're currently $13.64 each. So there's the price again, $13.64. And they're sold by Sill Blade, as you can see here, and this is Amazon.com. So this is Amazon.com's website, and you can get them a little bit cheaper here. And for a pair of them, I paid a total of $35.53, and that includes the shipping charge and tax for for two of these wiper blades. So that's one pair of wiper blades. Now, whenever I buy a product, I like to read what the packaging says for the product. So let's go ahead and read the packaging for one of these Sill Blades. Now, again, they're modeled WB122S's, or part number WB122S's. And again, they're made by Sill Blade. And their slogan is, "Lasts years, not months." It says they're PTFE coated silicone. It says it's a PTFE coated silicone wiper. Alright, you can see the instructions in there for them. And this is what the blade looks like. It says it's unaffected by sun or UV, which is ultraviolet light, unaffected by ozone, and unaffected by extreme temperatures. And we'll take a look at the back here. Again, it says lasts years, not months. It says patented silicone formula, durable, will not dry out or crack, leaves a micro-thin water-repellent coating on windshield, improves visibility. And I actually read that in the review, and the guy said he actually noticed a coating on his windshield from the wiper blades. Designed to improve maximum windshield contact, smooth operation. And they also say, they also talk about some of the other blades that they have available. They have their flex sill blades. So instead of a construction like this, where it has multiple pieces for the arm, the flex sill blades have a one-piece construction, I believe, like what I currently have on my vehicle. Then they have the unisill blades, and these are for original equipment, Japanese design hybrid blades, and it says uniblades there. And then they have rear sill blades, and it says original fit rear blade. So these would be wiper blades that go on the rear of a vehicle. Okay. It also says manufactured by an ISO 9001 certified company, which that's good, and meets or exceeds OEM or original equipment manufacturer specifications. And if that's true, that's good as well. And it also says Sill Blade products are protected under one or more of the following patents, and then they list the patents down below, which I can't see under the tag there. Okay, so this is the packaging for one of the Sill Blades. Now, before I open one of them up, I also wanted to note that one of the blades, or the packaging for one of the blades, was kind of beat up. So it was split here, and it looked like it may have been squashed, and somebody taped it back together. So that doesn't look too good, but hopefully the blade will be fine inside. So I'm going to go ahead and open up the other one, and we can take a look at the blade. Okay, so let's slide it out here. Get it untangled. Alright, so here's the blade. And let's take a look here. Turn it around. It says Sill Blade. And this is what the wiping surface looks like. And it's a multi-piece construction versus what I currently have on my vehicle, which is a one-piece blade that flexes instead of these stiff metal pieces that just move with hinges. It's a one-piece blade that flexes. So, and I'll show you that after I take those off the vehicle. So again, this is the new WB122S Sill Blade that I purchased, one of them. All right. And here is the point that it's mounted, or where it mounts onto the windshield wiper arm. Now, as I showed you previously, the first blade that I opened up, it appears to be fine. It appears to be undamaged, in good condition, new, and unused. Okay, but the second blade, I was wrong about that one. Now, that one was the one that was in this package that was beat up here. The side on it is split, and this section here looks like it's been crushed and taped back together again. And the one end of the blade looks fine, but as you get down towards the end, it is really badly damaged, and I don't know how the heck it got this way, because the box that it came in was fine, but it looks like possibly someone returned it to them. The container was damaged. They probably taped up the package and didn't notice that this blade was badly bent up, and they ended up just shipping it back out to me. So I'm going to have to contact Sill Blade, the seller, on Amazon.com and see if I can possibly just return this one blade, because I'd like to use the other good blade. Since now I don't have any good blades on my vehicle, I'd at least like to replace one of them with the good blade that I got, and return just this damaged one and get a replacement if they'll let me. Okay, it's Saturday, November 26th, 2016, and I was able to send back the damaged wiper blade that I showed you and get a replacement wiper blade just 2 or 3 days later. And Amazon.com makes it fairly easy to return a damaged item. I didn't have to return both of them. I was able to just send one of them back. They have a little button on their website that allows you to start the return process. And they even have a section where you can put in some comments about what you're returning, and a drop-down, or an item in their drop-down list that specifically talks about the scenario where the shipping box is undamaged but the packaging for the product is damaged. So it sounds like it's a scenario that they've definitely considered before. So again, I was able to return it with no problem and get a replacement. Also, another option that they provide you is if you don't have a printer, or if for some reason maybe your printer's not working, you can have their website display a QR code to you that has kind of a checker box or a checkerboard pattern in a square, and then also an alphanumeric code up above. And what you can do is take a picture of that code with your phone, and that will allow you to present that picture to the UPS store, and they will use that to print out a shipping label for you to put on your box if you don't have a printer to print it for yourself. Also, another lesson I learned by having this wiper blade damaged is that when you order stuff online, no matter what it is, you want to inspect the goods as soon as you get them. If you're like me, sometimes I have a tendency to get the stuff, put it away until I need it, and I may not need it for several months later. But really, it's a good idea to inspect the goods as soon as you get them, just in case they're damaged like the blades that I received. So that's a good lesson to remember, is to always inspect anything that you order online. Inspect it right away when you get it, just in case it's damaged and you have to send it back. Okay, so let's take a look at those blades again. And as you can see, this one's in good shape, nice and shiny and new. And so is this one here. Okay, and no twisted up ends. And the packaging is in good shape as well. All right, so let's go ahead and we'll take the old blades off and start installing these. Okay, so let's get started with the wiper blade on the passenger side. Now, I have my gloves on and my safety glasses, which I probably won't need, but it's always good to be on the safe side. I also have my flathead screwdriver, and they call it a flathead because it has a flat end on it. Alright, so that's a flathead screwdriver. And what I'm going to be doing is using this screwdriver to pry up this little piece here so that I can remove the wiper blade from the arm here. Alright, but before I do that, I'm going to put my sunshade underneath the wiper blade to protect it from the arm, or to protect the windshield from the arm. Okay, so now I have the sunshade underneath the wiper arm. I'll go ahead and I'll pry up on this piece here. Okay. And I'll just go ahead and I'll slide it off and take it out from the arm. And as you can see, if I were to let loose, if I let go of the arm, it just smacks into the sunshade and doesn't damage my windshield. So be sure to have something like a sunshade or an old bunched up blanket or an old folded up cardboard box and put it underneath the wiper arm so that you don't crack your windshield if you accidentally let loose of the wiper arm. So before I install the new blade on the passenger side, let's compare one of the new blades to the old blade and see the difference in construction of the two blades. So you can see the old blade here, and it's pretty much one continuous flexible piece right here, okay? And you can see the blade, or the rubber portion of the blade, is starting to tear away, and it wouldn't take much longer for it to come away completely. So this definitely has to be replaced. All right, and here is the new blade with a nice flexible edge on it. And as you can see, it's not a one-piece unit, okay? It has these small segments here, okay? There's four small segments right here, and those are hinged. And then another larger, two larger pieces here. And then finally, the main portion of the arm. And those hinges are what allow the blade to curve and fit the shape of your windshield. All right, and let's go ahead and take a close look at how they're mounted as well. So again, the little J-shaped hook of the wiper arm hooks around this piece here on the older blade, and if I'm thinking right, it should also hook around this piece right here, and those two little tabs in there should hold the arm, or should hold the blade in place on the wiper arm. So let's go ahead and we'll install the new wiper arm, or excuse me, the new wiper blade. Now, before we install the new wiper blade on the wiper arm, let's take a close-up look at the J-shaped end of the wiper arm so you can get an idea of what that looks like. So there we go. As you can see, it looks like a J, or kind of a backwards J in this picture here, but that's what the wiper blade is going to be mounted on. Okay, so let's go ahead and we'll install that new wiper blade. And again, we want to make sure that we have something in place to protect our windshield if we lose grip of the wiper arm there. Okay, so I'll put the blade underneath the wiper arm. And let's see here. I believe I've got to kind of angle it up. I think I'll have to angle it up like this. All right. So there we go. Kind of pull it onto the arm. All right, so it's in place. So it took a little bit of force to kind of pull it on there, but it should be good and secure. Okay, so here's a close-up of what it looks like when it's properly mounted. And as you can see here, there are the two little tabs here that hold the arm in place inside the wiper blade. And if I push on it, it stays good and secure. All right, so this is what it looks like. And again, this is the passenger side wiper blade. And now we'll go ahead and we'll start on the driver's side one. Now I'll go ahead and replace the driver's side windshield wiper blade. So what I first want to do is put the sunshade underneath the wiper blade to protect the windshield from the wiper arm. Then I want to pry up the piece that holds the wiper blade on the wiper arm. I'll pry that up, get that out of the way. Then I'll pull the wiper blade from the wiper arm. Set the wiper arm down. And as you can see, again, that sunshade protects the windshield from the bare wiper arm. And I'll slide the new wiper blade under the wiper arm. In fact, I'll have to put this piece up at a bit of an angle. All right, so hopefully you can see that there. Oops, let's try again. All right, and I'm gonna push it onto the wiper arm and it'll snap in place. And there we go, it's nice and secure. And now I can remove the sunshade. And there we go, two new wiper blades. Okay, so I've replaced the old torn up wiper blades with a pair of new sill blades that I purchased. And for everyone's reference, today is Saturday, November 26th, 2016. I have 5,009.4 hours on my engine and 146,270 miles on the vehicle. Now the last thing to do is to go ahead and test out the wiper blades. Now today it's not raining, so what I'm going to have to do is use the windshield spray to spray the windshield with some water and test out the blades. And as you can see, my windshield is pretty dirty. And over here you can also see a crack in my windshield, which that was not from a wiper blade, but that was from a rock that hit the windshield from a dump truck. And at first it started out as just a small little crack, but I waited too long to get it fixed, and so it spread down to the bottom of the windshield. So that's another little lesson for you. If you get a small little chip in your windshield, say for example like that one there, you want to try to get it fixed right away. But since I have that large crack there, I'm not going to bother fixing this windshield anymore. But let's go ahead and we'll test out the blades. And again, I'm going to use the spray for the windshield since it's not raining. And when you do this kind of test, you want to make sure you close your door. And we'll go ahead and let's see if we can get the wiper blades to start spraying. And they look like they're working pretty well. My windshield is nice and clean. We'll try another shot there. Okay, so I think I'm pretty happy with those new blades, and over time the windshield will get a lot cleaner. I should just wash it, but I'm a little too busy for that right now, so I'll just leave it dirty and let the wiper blades do the cleaning as I'm driving along. And hopefully we'll get some rain. Oh, and one other thing, according to the reviews that I read about these blades, they will eventually build up a little coating of PTFE on the windshield so that hopefully it'll make it look even cleaner and cause the water to bead off the windshield. So I'll have to watch for that and see how that works. And hopefully these blades, these sill blades, will last for many years to come. On their website, they actually claim that they, I believe their warranty is for 5 years. So I didn't see that on the packaging, but I believe on their website it says that they have a 5-year warranty. But again, I'd have to double check that.
Okay, it's Friday, January 20th, 2017, and I looked on sillblade.com, and as you can see, they do indeed have a 5-year warranty. Again, my name is Bobby Galuba with OobaTech.com. Thank you for watching, and I hope you learned something.